We'll take 24th, no problem. Half-life period of first order reaction is 1 minute 40 seconds, means 100 seconds. It's rate constant. Direct question, K is equal to 0.693 by T half. So substitute and simplify. 100 is 10 raised to minus 2, 10 raised to plus 2. Go to numerator, minus 2. So nothing but 6.93 into 10 raised to minus. That's as simple as that. So option C. 25th we'll take it. A plot of log A minus X by to the base 10 against time, log A minus X against 10 is a straight line with positive slope. This indicates that log A minus X is nothing but like log R plotted against time. So log R when plotted, it is first order if it is a straight line. Okay, then if it is a zero order, then R versus time you have to plot. So it should be first order. Okay. I think with positive slope is a kind of a thing we have to re-look into it, right? How do you get actually slope? When log A minus X against time is plotted, negative slope will be obtained, correct? Am I right or wrong? The graph will be moving down. Or you should say log A by A minus X when plotted against T, then you get a straight line, positive slope, of course. Do one thing, you slightly correct this question. Okay, log A, that is log A minus X in terms of log R against time is a straight line with a negative slope actually. It moves down. And slope becomes equal to minus k by 2.303, correct? K is equal to minus slope of 2.305. Anyhow, first order, you take it as negative slope, that's all. Make that correction. We'll take up further. 26th we'll take it. In a first order reaction, A by A minus X was found to be 8 after 10 minutes. I think I have worked out this. The rate constant is T is equal to 2.303 by K log A by A minus X. They have given the entire ratio as 8. So take log 8, that's all. So taking log 8, log book and all, they don't give. So how do you take up log 8? Anybody? How do you take log 8?
Log 2 power 3.
That's all. So we will simplify by taking log 8 as 2 power 3 is nothing but 3 log 2. Log 2 is 0.3010. First 5 numbers you need to know. Of course, they have directly given answer like this. In terms of the ratio itself, they have given like that. Okay, so fine. We'll take up this now. option A. Fine. Shall we proceed now? So this is option A for 26. We'll take up 27. A substance reacts with initial concentration of A mole per dm cube according to zero order kinetics. The time it takes for the completion of the reaction is, it's a zero order reaction. Initial concentration is A. In the place of R naught, it is A. The time it takes for completion. What is the time for 100% completion? R naught by what? What is the answer? Pranav Acharya has raised the hand. May I know?
Sir, C, sir.
Option C. It is nothing but R naught by K. In the place of R naught, you can just write A there. 27, option C. Okay. That's fine. So it is option C there. 28 will take it. The half-life period of nth order reaction is inversely proportional to. What is the relation between half life and nth order? It's the inversely proportional to. Looking at the response, 28 option A. A plus A power n plus 1. Option B. No, option B. Okay. That's fine. It's just the relation, that's all we had. So it's option B. T of proportional to 1 by A to the power n minus 1. Because inversely they have given, no problem. 29th we'll take up. Shall we? If a first order reaction takes 32 minutes for 75% completion, then time required for 50% completion is. How do you do it? They have given 75% completion is 32. Time required for 50% completion. Option B. People are giving option B now. Okay. Correct. Right. Now look at this. Usual way board method is, you know, they have given 32 minutes for 75%. You need to find out K there. K is equal to 2.303 by T log A by A minus X. A is 100. 75% completion means X is 75. A minus X is 25. Like that you have to proceed. So K is equal to 2.303 by T. T is 32 log 100 by 25 log 4.6021 multiply, then calculate K, then calculate time for 50%. T of is equal to for first order 0.693 by K. Otherwise, we know that different fractions have kind of relation with half-life. For 75% completion, it is always equal to 2 times half-life. Because if you take 100 moles in the beginning, in first half-life, 50 moles will be converted to products. In another half-life, one more half-life, what remains is 50, no? 50% of 50 is 25. So in two half-life, totally how much is converted? 50 plus 25, 75 is converted. What remains is 25. If remaining is 25, converted is 75. So 75% of a first order reaction just get completed in first two half-life itself. Okay? So 75% is two half-life. They're just asking. Time for 50%, it is 32 minutes divided by 2 is 60. That's all. Option B, as you people rightly. 30. At 500 Kelvin, the half-life period of a gaseous reaction at an initial pressure of 80 kilopascal is 350 seconds. When the pressure is 40 kilopascal, the half-life period is 175 seconds. The order of the reaction is, instead of concentration, they have given pressure. How do you go about it? Any answer? No chat masala. Aditi, A, 0. How would remaining? Aryan, A. Sanjana, A, fine. Next. That's all. Okay. Now, if you look at the thing, the at 80 kilopascal pressure, half-life is 350. when initial pressure has been brought down to 40 kilopascal, half life exactly becomes 50%. When initial pressure is 50%, so that means half life is directly proportional to initial concentration. That's what we can say. Now, whether it's concentration or pressure, if it is directly proportional to half life, when pressure decreases, half life also decreases proportionately, is a characteristic property of zero order reaction. Okay, so of course, if for nth order, T of proportional to 1 over a power n minus 1, for zero order, half life becomes proportional to a. Okay, fine. We'll take 31st question. Time for 50% of a first order reaction is 10 minutes. Starting with 10 mole per liter, rate after 20 minutes is? Come on. Time for 50% of a first order reaction is 10 minutes. Starting with 10 mole per liter, rate after 20 minutes is? Now, rate is always equal to K into molar concentration of reactant as per the rate equation. So after 20 minutes rate they are asking. You have to consider rate is equal to K into molar concentration of reactant after 20 minutes, not initial concentration. So based on that you have to decide on. Option A. What about remaining guys? Many people are not responding. Now I'll call out the names. No response, I say. Suddenly you people have stopped. What about remaining? Now. B. Okay. So same question, different people, different answers. Same question should have same answer, no? Fine. We'll take up this now here. See, time for 50% is half life. 10 minutes. They have started with 10 moles. After 20 minutes, no doubt that 10 moles would have got reduced. If half-life is 10 minutes, in 20 minutes, there are two half-lives. Two half-life is equal to 75% of the reaction. Just now we have seen. 75% of 10 mole got converted means. How much is 75% of 10 mole? 7.5 mole. How much is remaining? 2.5. Rate is always proportional to remaining concentration. Rate is equal to K into remaining concentration, that is, whatever they have given, 0.0693 by K into 2.5, we have to do that. Okay. So, based on that, okay, let me explain this. 10 moles they have taken. Half life means it becomes 5 after 10 minutes. In one more half life, it becomes 2.5. Look at this once again. So rate is equal to K into R is the equation which we calculate rate at any given concentration. So after 20 minutes, two half lives, 2.5 mole is remaining. But what is K? They have not given K directly. So K is nothing but 0.693 by half life. Half life is 10. So 0.693 by 10 into concentration 2.5 is the answer. So it is not D or B or A. It is rather... Where is that? B it is. Sorry. 0.693 by 10 is nothing but 0.0693 into 2.5. Option B is correct. Okay. Fine. So I think that this problem, you have to look at the 20 minutes after the remaining concentration. The rate is equal to always K into remaining concentration at that time. So 20 minutes has two half lives. After two half lives, starting with 10 mole, how much remains is 2.5. Here K is not given. So 0.693 by half, just substitute and you will get it. We'll proceed now. 32. Which of the following graph is correct for a first order reaction? Anybody? You give the answers like 32 dot option so that I may get confused with previous questions like that. Is it so difficult, man? It's almost memory based. Come on. What is the correct answer? 32 option B. Okay. Remaining are not understanding. 32B. Can anybody tell me? See, correct, they are asking. Now, for first order reaction, when you plot half life against initial concentration, as initial concentration increases, half life decreases. What is the characteristic of half life period for a first order reaction? Half life decreases or increases with concentration or something else?
Independent of.
Correct. No. That being the case, how do you think that the graph, if it has to be correct here, option B, should look like? If this graph has, this is wrong, therefore, correct, no? If half life is independent of concentration, this should not be the graph. How should it look like?
Straight line parallel to R naught axis.
Okay. It should be parallel to R, that means x axis here. So at any concentration, half life is constant. It has to be parallel to x axis. Now, then which is correct here? So then people are again giving A now. Okay. Now A log R naught by R, A by A minus X versus time is straight line passing through origin. Okay. If you take a integrated rate equation for first order, K is equal to 2.303 by T. Log R naught by R. Retain log R naught by R there and transfer rest to the right hand side. So that it becomes KT divided by 2.30. So log R naught by R is equal to KT divided by 2.30. There is no y intercept and there is no negative sign out, which means a straight line with positive slope and no y intercept means from origin. So log R naught by R versus time gives a straight line with a positive slope passing through the origin. That's the meaning. So it's correct. Right? You look at this, see how exactly concentration varies in a reaction. Same thing, no? As reaction proceeds with time, concentration decreases and slowly it goes and touches the x axis. Wherever it touches, reaction is complete. So C also must be correct.
They have indicated products.
So there is actually molar concentration of product. If you doesn't pay attention towards that, then this graph also appears to be correct. Actually, it is wrong. For the reason, it is for product. If it is R here, then the graph is correct. For product, exactly inverted. This comes there, this goes there, inverted. So option A is the correct answer. Okay. Fine. We'll proceed to next question. For a certain reaction, a plot of concentration of the reactant against time gives a straight line passing through the origin, the order of the reactions. The plot of concentration of reactant against time gives a straight line passing through the origin. What is the order of the reaction? Anybody? 32A. Vinay? 33? What about people? I say there are many vibrant personalities. Why you people are very quite silent, man? 33C, second order. No, I'm not getting the answer. That's all. Okay. Now, if you give correct answer for this, you can be awarded with any prize, Nobel Prize. Prerna 33B. Sir, I have doubt. Come on, please ask me. Sanjana, tell me. Pardon me? 33 option B or C?
Sir, it's given us through origin, no, sir.
So? No, who is speaking? Sanjana or who is speaking actually?
Man, sir.
Nilesha. There you go, but the, who is this? Sanjana KM?
Sir, naan sir maatadtirudu.
Helaya? Helo. Adishayadi, what do you decide on this? So what should you say now?
Nota.
Exactly. See, look at this. For a certain reaction, a plot of concentration of the reactant against time gives a straight line passing through origin. Is it possible in any reaction? You tell me. Okay. See, concentration against time, like this. As time proceeds, concentration of reactant increases. Huh? So, only one typo error there. So let's correct it. For a certain reaction, a plot of concentration of reactant against half-life model, half-time. Make this as half-time. Look at the cursor. Half-time, half-time, half-time. Okay, if you have done with it, I'll reread it again. A plot of concentration of reactant against half-time gives a straight line passing through origin. Then which is correct? I think you can answer now. Come on, man. Nota. Sir, my microphone is not working, Sanjana. How come suddenly it becomes like that? Now people have given, there is a lot of life now. Option A. Okay. That's fine, I say. You changed it, no? So you have to change. Then only option A is correct. Otherwise, question cannot be correct. Half time or half life, you say. We take 34. Come on. In a first order reaction, the concentration of reactant decreases from 8 mole per dm cube to 0.5 mole per dm cube in 2 into 10 raised to 4 seconds. Rate constant of the reaction is?
Option D.
2.8 into 10 raised to minus 4.
Yes, sir.
Okay, how do you go about it? 8 mole per dm cube is initial concentration. 0.5 mole per dm cube is remaining concentration.
Yes, sir.
Then you calculate K, yeah?
Sir, it is independent of concentration.
Half-life.
Sir.
Half-life is the first order, the concentration. No, why? What is that? First, I have to reread the question now. suddenly if you become like the concentration of the reactant decreases so and so rate constant, they are asking independent of initial concentration. Means what, madam? I didn't get you. What is your answer? You made me to read again.
Idralli third option illi
kanutte sir. Third option same idiya?
Third option it pomodu sir.
ಈಗ ಎರಡರಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದು ಅಂತ ಏನ್ ನ್ಯೂಮರಾಲಜಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕಾ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಈಗ
ಸರ್? ಅಪ್ರಾಕ್ಸಿಮೇಷನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು
ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ನಮ್ಮ ತೂರ್ಗಲ್ ಸರ್ ಏನ ಕೇಳ್ಬೇಕು ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರೇಷನ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸಿಯೇಷನ್ ಏನಾದ್ರು ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಫೈನ್ ಮಿಸ್ ನೀಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಅಪ್ ನೌ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ see one way is usual method I say take 8 as initial concentration 0.5 as a minus x or r then calculate what k that is okay you can say one or two steps in this method 8 to 0.5 mole will happen in how many half life you see half life is time for 50% conversion 8 becomes 4 in one half life 4 becomes 2 in another half life one more half life one more half life so like that 8 becomes 0.5 in how many half life four half lives what has been given so it is converted in what time 2 into 10 raised to 4 seconds so four half life is 2 into 10 raised to 4 so one half life is divided by 4 5 into 10 raised to 3 1 by 2 correct no 1 by 2 0.5 5 into 10 raised to 3 that is half life then directly calculate k 0.693 by 5 into 10 raised to 3 1.38 into 10 raised to minus 4 and now somebody told me option d like that and then some people went for probability calculation and all it is option c unfortunately huh 1.38 into 10 raised to minus 5 otherwise you go for integrated rate equation that is I think this is calculation wise log and all is not there it's simple right now if you have done writing I'll proceed to 35 slowly people many people have become non responsive in the beginning you people who used to respond they also become non responsive always like that no in the beginning it will be fantastic slowly it's okay kind of attitude changes Durgashree C, Prerana D. After my answer given, it is option C only. Now you can give correct answers. That's a different thing. Thank you. Yes, sir. Finished writing. Microphone is not correct. So therefore, we go for chat. Fine. We'll go for next 35th question. I'll read out. Half-life period of a first order reaction is 12 hours starting from 100 gram of the reactant okay 100 gram of the reactant amount of reactant left over at the end of 60 hours half life they are given they are going to start with 100 grams after 60 hours how much is left behind
6.3
option
D 1.5 ah 6.3 B okay B Bengaluru
okay oh it's not you know any no, other city. Okay that's fine you want Bangalore only that's fine it cannot be 6.3 Mr. Neil check once again
sir it's 3 grams sir
3 grams ah it's a pranav okay option c so bengaluru boys are wrong we'll take up now solution see total time for which 100 gram is reduced is 60 hours at the end of 60 hours 100 gram become what you how much you know it get reduced we need to find out So in 60 hours, how many half-lives are there? Half-life is given. 60 by 12 is equal to 5 half-lives. So all that is required is, for in 5 half-life, 100 becomes how much? So 150, 25, 12.5, 6.25, 3.125. 5 half-lives. Don't say 100 like that. In 1 half-life, 50, you have to count it as one. Just that, you know. Otherwise, you look at this. 100 becomes 50, 1 half-life. 25, 2, 12.5, 3, 6.25, 4, 3.125, it is 5. So, in 60 hours, which is nothing but 5 half-lives, what remains is 3.12 grams. Option C is appropriate. Bangalore, not correct. Calcutta is correct.
Chennai.
Shall we proceed now? 36. Half-life period of a first order reaction is, come on. Pranav Acharya raises hand. Simply after writing for a long time, we'll do like this. No, is that is the thing? What is the grievance, Mr. Pranav Acharya? Any? Come on, tell me.
By mistake, sir.
Huh?
By mistake, sir.
Okay. You can answer meanwhile.
See, sir.
Independent of the initial concentration of the reaction. Okay. So that's all. So memory based. Half-life, first order reaction is independent of initial concentration. Fine. Options. 37. Consider a first order gas phase decomposition reaction. A giving rise to B plus C. The initial pressure of the system before decomposition of A was Pi. After time t, total pressure of system is increased by x units and became Pt. The rate constant K for the reaction is expressed as. This is based on gaseous phase. Let me see, some of you would have done at least this kind of problems. I'll be giving you about 30 to 40 minutes, 40 seconds. Let's see how many of you can come out with the correct answer. Come on, work out. Sanjana is answering 38th question. You have answered faster than what I could expect, actually. Yes. That's okay. Right. Since people are answering faster, let me take up the solution. Now, this is gaseous phase reaction. Write the reaction whatever they have given. A gas giving rise to B plus C gases. Now, in such cases, you just need to find out how much is initial reacted remaining. Because in the expression of integrated rate equation, R naught divided by R is there. Since in gaseous phase reaction, R naught is equal to Pi. R is equal to Pt, we say, remaining concentration. Correct. Now, initial pressure. Then we'll take up details of reacted pressure at time t, remaining pressure. Now, let's say initial pressure for A is PI, PI or P naught, anything you can take, PI. As per the answers or options, you can take PI. Initial applies for reactants, not for products, so put dash there. Out of 1 mole, X will react. For 2 mole, 2X will react, like that only we generally take. X is the amount of A reacted out of 1 mole. So PI is the initial pressure. What is reacted is X. So PI minus X would be the remaining pressure of A. At the same time, if you look at the proportion by which A, B and C are formed, A 1 mole, B 1 mole, C 1 mole. So if X mole is reacting, so 1 into X, 1 into X, X mole of B, X mole of C will be formed. So like that. So this is remaining of A, this is B, this is C. We need to find out X here and substitute, and therefore you can find out remaining partial pressure of reactant A after some time T. Okay, for that what we do, total pressure at time T given is after time T in the question, right? So total pressure at time T, PT is equal to, add this partial pressure of reactant products X and X. One X cancels, what remains is PT is equal to PI plus X. So therefore, X is equal to PT minus PI. X is equal to PT minus PI. Right? Now, X value has been found out. What do we do? So remaining pressure at remaining pressure of reactant A at time T is given by this. Why is this required, first of all? Why remaining pressure of A is required? Because in the integrated rate equation, at the end, log R0 by R is there. R0 is nothing but PI. R is nothing but remaining concentration of reactant. In a gaseous phase reaction, remaining partial pressure of reactant A. As per this representation here, remaining partial pressure of reactant A is PI minus X. We need to find out this only, PI minus X. For that, X is required. We have found out X here. Substitute X here, you will get remaining partial pressure of reactant A. So remaining partial pressure, pressure of reactant A is a T is equal to PI minus X is what? PT minus PI. PT minus PI. So what would happen? PI plus PI, 2PI minus PT. Correct, no? So you have to just understand for gaseous reaction, R0 is PI and R is P. In some textbooks, they give T and all. As per the question, whatever they have referred the symbols, like that only we'll take. So they have given total pressure increases by PT like that. So now what remains is P, that's all. So in the denominator, R will be there. R is nothing but P. In the place of P, you write 2PI minus PT. In the place of R0, you write PI. So which integrated rate equation holds good with this? K is equal to 2.303 by T log R0 by R. In the place of R0, PI. In the place of R, it is nothing but P, which is 2PI minus P. So this part is important, especially for gaseous reaction. These kind of things has to be found out because remaining partial pressure we have to find out. So, are you writing? Should I wait?
Done, sir.
Aditi Banu, any problem? Done. Oh, it's done. That's why I raised the hand. Is that the thing? Okay, thank you. If you have written, I'll proceed now. If the initial concentration is tripled, the time for half reaction is also tripled. The order of the reactions. I think similar questions we have seen. No problem. I'll directly go with the solution. So half-life is directly prone to concentration for zero order. So they have given initial concentration is tripled, time for half also triples, means half life triples. So it is directly proportional, it is 0 odd. 39. In the fermentation of sugar, the concentration is reduced from 0.12 molar concentration to 0.06 molar in 10 hours and to 0.03 molar in 20 hours, the order of the reactions. 0.12 becomes 0.06 in 10 hours. Again, 0.12 becomes 0.03. That's how unto, when I say that, 0.3 molar in 20 hours, the order of the reactions. So, option one, people are answering with option one. Option D, 0. Pranav. What about remaining? Okay, we'll proceed with the solution. Got one more response. Sir, I changed to D. Okay. You have done wrong, I say. Okay, listen to me now. Solution. What has been given? 0.12 mole has become 0.06. Then it is reduced to 0.03. That's all. Now 0.12 becomes 0.06 in first half life. Why do you consider as half life? Because exactly half. 0.12 divided by 2, 0.06. So half of the reaction is complete in 10 hours. So 10 hours is half life. Now, also they have given, it is then reduced to 0.03 in 20 hours. Obviously, no, 0.12, if it has to be converted to 0.03, one more half-life must be spent. We have just decided half-life is 10 hours. In one more half-life, that is in 20 hours, 0.12 becomes 0.03. So this phase is second half-life. Correct, no? What does it mean again? Half-life is constant. From this explanation, what we can say? Whatever is the initial concentration, 0.12 or 0.06, half-life remains the same. So it's a characteristic property of first order. So half-life is constant independent of initial concentration. Therefore, it is first order reaction. I'll go back. It is first order reaction. Now, probably you people would have got confused. Independent when it comes. What is independent is what? That is important. And when you doesn't revise things will be completely confused. RN. I changed to do D, sir. Not like that. Mr. RN, you should read like, in fermentation of sugar, the concentration is reduced from 0.12 molar to 0.06 molar in 10 hours and 0.03 molar in 20. So first in 10 hours it is that. Then 0.12 becomes 0.03 in 20 hours life. Is that okay? You have to consider and 2 when I say that. It is 0.12 to 0.03 total from the beginning to 0.03. It is 20 hours. Which simply means that each case half life is spent. So half life is independent of initial concentration. Therefore it is first half life. Now I was telling. So what is confusing? This independent word. At different orders, something is independent. In zero order, what is independent? And in first order, what is independent is important. Can anybody tell me? If I use the word in zero order, independent, what is independent of what? Anybody? Can unmute and tell me? Independent. Because that is confusing. In zero order, what is independent of what?
Rate is independent of concentration.
Rate is independent of concentration. In first order, what is independent of what?
TF is independent of.
Half-life is independent of initial concentration. Like that, you should remember. Okay. Now, something doubles, then something also doubles. This is one another fact which confuses us. One doubles, another also doubles. There are two things. In zero order, what will double and another also quantity which will also double? What are the two things which will double?
EF and the concentration.
In case of zero order, concentration when doubles, half life doubles. In case of first order, what will double? Other also will double.
Concentration doubles, rate doubles.
Look at that. These are all confusing things. You have to write down after my class. Write down there. How half life and rate vary with zero order and first order. Then things will be clear. We'll take up next. 40th. 8 gram of radioactive isotope cesium-137 were collected on February 1st last year. Okay. And kept in a sealed tube on July 1st of the same year. Okay. It was found that only 0.25 gram of it remained. So the half-life period of the isotope. It is a popular question actually. Examination question. So it's been given here also. Come on.
25 days.
Pardon me? 30, what is that? 30 days, huh? Okay. 48th option B. Saksha. Ziba. Good. Aditi. Bhumika. I think people have given an answer. We'll take a first. Sanjeev. From February 1st to July 1st, how many months are there? July should not be counted. July 1st, we started with February 1st. February, March, April, May, June. July should not be counted. 5 months. So in 5 months, what has happened there? Okay. In 5 months, from July, February to July, 8 gram of radioactive isotope, which has been converted to 0.25. Only 0.25 is remaining. So what we can say in 5 months span, if 8 gram becomes 0.25 gram, how many half-life it would have spent? Let's find. Okay. So this is how we exactly. Now 8 mole become 4, 4, 2, 2, 1, 0.5, 0.25. So how many half-lives are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. Totally 5 half-lives are required, 8 to 0.25. 5 half-lives is nothing but 5 months. So therefore, each half-life is equal to 1 month, that is 30. You make a count that, February is 29, sir. March will be 31. Okay, overall you have to consider. So it will be, not to worry, approximately 30 days. Right? So option B is correct. 41. A first order reaction is half completed in 45 minutes. Okay. The time required for 99.9% of the reaction to be completed. Or to complete is. Immediately, anybody? It is a question which is immediately answered. It has to be immediately answered. Vinay Bhandara, B. 20 hours. 41D, Aditi Banu, 7.5. Prerna D. Siddharth D, account open. Okay, Sanjana D. Okay. I think we have got in the beginning some other answers. B like that.
sir. That was for last question, sir.
Okay, Vinay. What is your answer now? Now it is D, your time. Okay, fine. Okay. We'll take a further. Solution. See, regular method is this. What is the regular method? Time required for 99% completion. A is 100 there. Completion is X there. A minus X is 0.1. That's how exactly you go. So K, again, we require K. They have given first order half complete in 45 minutes. You can calculate K by 0.693 by 45. Time for 99% is equal to 2.303. K is this ratio. Log 100 by 0.1. 100 by 0.1 is 1000. Log 1000 is 3. Substitute simplify, you will get 450 minutes. But actually, since it is half life and 99.9%, you can go. See, 99.9% is 10 times a half life period. You have proved it also. There was a proof. Prove that time required for first order reaction to complete by 99.9% is 10 times the half life period. So you have to use these conclusions. Like T75 is 2 times half life. T87.5 is equal to 3 times half life. T99.9% is equal to 10 times half life. Correct? No? T90% is 3.32 times half life. See, these are all the things which you have to remember. So, not like in every problem you can use this. Wherever that ratio relation is there, you can go for that. It gives just in one or two steps. T99 is 10 times half life. 10 times half life is 45 into 10, 450. 450 divided by 60 will give 7.5 hours. So, that's how exactly some of you have done. I know option D is correct. Okay, we'll proceed. 42nd. If rate law for a reaction is R is equal to K into A power P, that is power actually, and B power minus P by Q, that is, please read it properly. Little printing is a problem there. R is equal to K into A power P, B power minus P by Q. Minus P by Q, then order of the reaction is immediately. It is minus. Ananya, C. Since it is negative, there is little thing required. Otherwise, sum of the powers of the concentration terms is nothing but order of the reaction. So we'll check up this now. It is P minus P by Q you have to do. Take the Q LCM. It is nothing but P by Q into Q minus 1. Correct? So option C is correct. We'll go to next question. Assume A to be initial concentration, half-life to be, T of to be half-life, fine. Identify which of the following representation in a second order reaction is correct. Identify which of the following represents a second order reaction. Come on. Which of the following represents second order? Sorry. B. Option B. Okay. Right one. Fine. Correct. Now, I'll just point out the cursor. You have to tell me that particular graph represents what. Be spontaneous. Unmute and tell me. What is this? Option A represents what?
Zero order.
Good. Option B?
Second order.
That is the correct answer. Option C.
First order.
Option D.
Fourth order.
Fourth order is there, man. Half-life versus A. It went like that. Huh? Let's look at that. We say no. Devre Gatin. Now, half-life versus A is zero order like this. Half-life versus A is a straight line like this. So when you plot half-life versus A like this, if it is not giving any of these two, we can conclude it is not first order, it is not zero order. Neither zero order, because only in case of zero and first order, we plot half-life versus initial concentration. In case of second and third order, we go for reciprocals like this to get a straight line. As a result, we can either, whatever the information directly is provided, half-life versus A is not a straight line, means not obviously a zero order, and it is not even parallel because it is a curve, so it is not even first order. And is it a second order? Then we have to check with 1 by A. We don't know that. Because for second order and third order, 1 by A, 1 by A square will plot. So that's the conclusion. Anyhow, so answer is for this question, option 44. Come on. After four half-lives, the amount of substance left over was 5 grams. The initial amount of the substance taken is. Come on. You should immediately give the answer for this, I say. Tasneem Firdos is option C. Correct. So Sanjana 80, Samiksha 80, Adhi Banu C, I, Vinay C. Okay. It is just back calculating. You can do like this. Better, it is always better to pin down. However, sure you are, because you may get confused in your absent-mindedness or something. Anyway, 4 half-life. 5 becomes 10, 20, 40, 80, 4. No problem. We can go for the solution like this. In the reverse direction, no? That's why I have given reverse arrow marks. Look at this. 5 becomes 10 in 1. That means before 1 half-life, it would have been 10. Before 2 half-life, it would have been 20, 40, 80. So 80 grams. Or you can take 80 gram and do 4 half-life, 5 grams remains. Not a problem. We'll take up next. 45. 1 molar, 0.5 molar and 2 molar. Solutions of hydrogen peroxide. 1 molar, 0.5 molar, 2 molar H2O2. Solutions are separately allowed to decompose under same conditions of temperature and pressure. The half-life period is. Half-life period is.
Same for all.
Why?
First order reaction, H2O2 decomposition. So it's independent of concentration. Half-life.
That's fantastic. Complete answer. Good. That's all the answer. Yes, I'm getting the answers, option D. Correct? Now look at this. Exactly what he said. Decomposition of hydrogen peroxide, certain very important reactions, often given as examples for various orders, must be remembered. And as many as possible is always better. Okay? At least important ones. So, no, option C is wrong actually. You take it as D only, okay? H2O2 decomposition follows first order kinetics and half-life is independent of initial concentration. So you take any 1 molar, 0.5 molar, 2 molar or any concentration, half-life remains the same. You take it as D, there is some type of error. 45 D. Okay. Yeah. So with these many questions, problems related to integrated rate equation, half-life and thereby order, we have solved. enough? Definitely not. It's a sample question, that's all. In a crash course, sample. In regular course also, that itself is a sample actually. You may work out 50 questions or in regular class, little more. But definitely it is not sufficient. It's only touching at different concepts and varieties. But it is damn sure that you have to work out into 5 times more. Okay. We'll take up further concepts in this chapter. So one more last dose of chemical kinetics, where after this we are going to wind up this chapter. So effect of temperature on rate of reaction. This is one another factor. As I told you in the beginning of the chapter, three aspects are studied importantly: concentration, effect of temperature, effect of catalyst. So problems related to all the three are very important, especially concentration. Effect of temperature on rate of reaction. What is known? Rate of a reaction increase with increase in temperature is a fact which is based on experimentation. For most of chemical reactions, the rate becomes double for every 10 degree or 10 Kelvin rise in temperature. Rise would be same whether it is degree or Kelvin. In some cases, of course, reaction rate would vary beyond double time also. It may be triple also. This can be expressed in terms of temperature coefficient of a reaction. If you want to know how rate varies with concentration, order. If you want to know how rate varies with temperature, temperature coefficient. Is this constant? What is temperature coefficient? It is the ratio of rate constant of a reaction at two different temperatures differing by 10 Kelvin or 10 degrees centigrade. So how do we give equation? KT plus 10 by KT. No problem. That will vary. Temperature coefficient will be varying between 2 to 3. That's what we say experiment. Explanation for effect of temperature. Why for every rise in 10 degrees centigrade, why rate of for the reaction has to double? For that, we will consider concept of activation energy. What is under that? What is activation? How it is helping reaction to increase rate by 2 times for every 10 Kelvin rise? What is important concept? Effective collisions are important to form products which require threshold energy. Now, in one sentence I've given, when two reactants are reacting in a reaction, they have to collide. But all normal collisions would not result in the formation of product. There must be effective collision. Effective collision cannot happen with normal energy or average energy. There should be high energy. The high energy required by reactants to undergo effective collision to form the products is what is threshold energy. So effective collisions are important for to form the products which requires threshold energy. What is threshold energy? Minimum high energy required by reactant to undergo effective collisions. Of course, you can extend to form the products. It's called threshold energy. Then, but most of the reactants will have average energy or low energy. With that energy, they can undergo normal collision where no change can happen. So in order to undergo effective collision, reactant molecules must have to have some excess energy above their normal energy. That excess energy required above normal energy is what is activation. Hence, it is minimum excess energy required to be acquired by normal molecules in order to form activated complexes called activation energy. So activation energy is equal to threshold energy minus energy of normal molecules. Like that, we can say in catalysis, we say energy of activated complex minus energy of normal molecule is activation. Example, reaction between H2 and I2 results in the formation of HI. Correct? No? First, when H2 I2 react directly doesn't give HI, as per this, they undergo collision. Momentarily, they form activated complex. Activated complex is that complex which has high energy, low stability. Therefore, once it is formed, it immediately decomposes to give products. So effective collision must result in the formation of activated complex intermediately. If activated complex is not formed, it would not give products. So for this H2 and I2 reacting to give HI, we can plot this energy profile diagram like this. Energy along y-axis, reaction progress or reaction coordinate along y-axis. Now this is the point along the y-axis which indicates energy of H2 and I2. When they undergo effective collision, they form high energy complex. This is what is represented as high energy complex, which then immediately decomposes to form the product HI. And this is the overall reaction, H2 reacting to give activated complex, giving rise to products. this peak corresponds to threshold energy, and energy required for by H2 and I2 normal reactant molecule to attain that threshold energy is what is activation energy. Is that okay? It then decomposes to give products, and that height of threshold energy is also activation energy barrier. Is that okay? So that's the energy profile diagram for H2. This is how the concept of activation energy is required. So this height is what is activation energy. Now, if you want, you can also tell one thing here. If this height is more, okay, if this follow the cursor, if this height is more, then reactant molecules have to cross a very big energy barrier. Such molecules may be less in number in the reaction mixture. So wherever activation energy is more, rate of reaction will be less. Wherever height is less, activation energy is less, more and more reactant molecule can easily cross the low energy barrier. So activation energy decreases, rate of the reaction increases, and vice versa. Also, this Maxwell-Boltzmann energy distribution curve is used to explain effect of temperature. Actually, fraction of molecules with a given kinetic energy or energy, Ne by Nt is also the fraction. A number of molecule with energy, given energy divided by total number of molecule. Ne by Nt, they say, or fraction of the molecule. Along x-axis, energy of those molecules. So we are going to plot for a reacting system at T degrees centigrade and 10 plus more degrees centigrade. So T and T plus 10 Kelvin, so degrees centigrade. At low temperature, 10 degree low temperature, the curve is obtained like this. Okay. High energy part is what is threshold energy. And molecules which cross the threshold energy barrier will be possessing activation energy and also called as activated molecules. So at T degree centigrade, only these many molecules, follow the cursor, only these many molecules have threshold energy. At T plus 10 degrees centigrade, you can see the number of molecules which are crossing the threshold energy barrier by acquiring activation energy doubles. When it doubles, effective collisions double, rate of the reaction also doubles. That is Maxwell-Boltzmann energy distribution diagram. So for every rise in 10 degrees centigrade, molecules which cross energy barrier and become activated double, effective collision doubles, rate of the reaction doubles. That's the main. Next is Arrhenius equation. What is it about Arrhenius equation? It relates rate constant, activation energy, and temperature of a reacting system. Very important. So these are the aspects which are related to one another, which affect the rate of a reaction. Correct? The Arrhenius equation is K is equal to A into E to the power minus A by RT. K is rate constant. What is A? Arrhenius frequency factor, pre-exponential factor, also we say. What does it give? It is equal to the number of collisions between the reactant molecules per second per unit volume. How many collisions are possible? That is A. EA is activation energy, and R in the equation is gas constant, you know, T is absolute temperature. E to the power minus A by RT whole thing indicates. Pardon me? Adishesh, any problem? I think you have got unmuted this. Okay. We'll proceed. So Boltzmann factor also we call E to the power minus E by RT is Boltzmann factor. No problem. Okay. Now, it is evident from Arrhenius equation that other factors being constant, okay, the rate of reaction rate, what is that man? Other factors being constant, as value of EA decreases, you can see here, it is a negative power of the activation energy for exponential term. So as EA decreases, negative power decreases. That means value increases, means K increases. That's the meaning. It is negative. Negative, if EA decreases, negative power decreases means overall value increases, which means K increases. That's the conclusion mathematically we can derive from Arrhenius equation. K increases and the rate of the reaction also increases. Other forms of Arrhenius equation. You can apply log to this Arrhenius equation as there is exponential. Log to base U, you will first apply and then multiply by 2.3. Then you get two forms of Arrhenius equations. Correct, no? The two forms of Arrhenius equation are more significant in calculating activation energy and such kind of things. So log K is equal to log A minus A by 2.303 RT. Okay. This is one form. Which is the other form? Log K2 by K1 is equal to A divided by 2.303 R T2 minus T1 by T1 T2. Or 1 over T1 minus 1 over T2 also you can say. Here in the second equation, sometimes when you know two temperatures of reactions and corresponding rate constants, T1, K1, T2, K2, activation energy can be calculated, or they give any four known quantities, one unknown quantity can be calculated. Similarly, this equation can be used graphically to calculate activation energy because this equation is similar to Y is equal to mx plus C. Why that equation is similar to Y is equal to mx plus C? Here again, two variables are there. Temperature is independent variable. When temperature changes, K, rate constant also changes, which is a dependent variable. Calculation of activation energy graphically by using that equation. Arrhenius equation represents a straight line. As per the equation, this Y is equal to mx plus c. What is x here? X is 1 by t. What is y here? Y is log k. That means what? When you plot y against x, means log k against 1 by t, you get a straight line. There is a minus sign here with a negative slope. So slope m is equal to minus a by 2.303 r, or ea is equal to minus slope into 2.303 r, and c is equal to log a. Y-intercept C. Therefore, if you can calculate Arrhenius frequency factor also, A is equal to anti-logarithm of C. Looking at this, log K against 1 by T. You can see if you calculate slope, M is equal to minus A by 2.303 R. So, A is equal to minus slope into 2.303 R. Okay. So, and of course, you can also add this. If you extrapolate, it will touch the Y-axis, that is Y-intercept. C is equal to log A and A is equal to anti-logarithm of C. So this is about the Arrhenius equations and activation energy and all those things. Now you tell me, the reactions, organic reactions and inorganic reactions, which are faster? Organic and inorganic, which are faster?
Inorganic.
Organic reactions and inorganic, which one has high activation energy? Organic, inorganic, which one has high activation energy?
Organic.
Organic reactions has high, because activation energy, when it increases, what happens to rate? Decreases. So organic reactions are moderate in rate. Inorganic reactions are ionic, instantaneous. So therefore, organic reactions are slow, their activation energy in general should be high compared to inorganic. Okay. So then comes, in Arrhenius equation, K is equal to A into e to the power minus A by RT. As temperature tends to infinity, what would happen to the reaction? What would be the conclusion you could derive from the equation? As temperature tends to infinity, what happens to the K? Anybody?
Decreases.
One important conclusion we can derive based on Arrhenius. As temperature tends to infinity, what happens to K? Anybody?
Numerically equal to Arrhenius factor.
So, what could be the conclusion based on that? If K becomes equal to A, what does it mean? Any conclusion you can derive out of that? Based on this equation, as temperature tends to infinity, K becomes equal to A, what does it mean? A constant becoming equal to constant, that's nothing means. There is no meaning. Is that the thing? Anybody? Come on. Anybody responding? No chat masala. Neil. What about remaining people? I say. What happens? What is the conclusion? Somebody told me correctly. K becomes equal to. Huh? No idea. Now listen to me. When temperature increases, this ratio decreases and it becomes infinity. So completely this e power 0 will become 1. Then k becomes equal to a. K becoming equal to a means rate constant becoming equal to Arrhenius frequency factor, which is a constant. What does it mean? See, in this equation, when temperature changes, when temperature slowly increases, Ea decreases. Negative power of Ea, if it decreases, overall value increases, the product. So K increases. That's how exactly. But if temperature becomes infinity, that is, of course, hypothetical, of course. This entire term will become zero, means in that reaction, where temperature is infinity, there will be no temperature term at all in the Arrhenius equation, meaning there is no effect of temperature on rate constant. We have seen so far, rate constant depends on concentration of reactants, but is rate constant depends on temperature of the reaction and is independent of concentration. Here, when temperature becomes infinity, rate constant becomes independent of temperature and it becomes equal to zero. Okay, so the same thing also can be concluded when activation energy of a reaction is zero. Correct? No. When activation energy of the reaction is zero, again this becomes zero. E to the power zero is equal to one. So K becomes equal to. That means K becomes independent of temperature. In such cases, even if you alter temperature condition of the reaction by 10 Kelvin or whatever, rate constant value doesn't double. That's the meaning. Of course, it is purely hypothetical case. Okay. So this is one thing. So after that, we have effect of catalyst on the rate of the reaction. A catalyst is a substance which alters the rate of a chemical reaction. Condition is without itself undergoing any chemical change. Of course, we dealt with the catalyst types, all those things in surface chemistry. But here, the theory deals with how catalyst increase the rate of a reaction. Okay. Now, when you use a catalyst, of course, same reaction mechanism will be there. Reactants have to collide effectively to form activated complex. The activated complex, once it is formed, it is high energetic, less stable, immediately decomposed to give products. Catalyst X will be regenerated always. In this process, energy required to form activated complex from the reactants involving catalyst is what is activation energy. In the absence of catalyst, energy required to form activated complex will be very high. In the presence of catalyst, activation energy required to form activated complex decreases. When activation energy decreases, rate of the reaction increases. So one sentence conclusion for catalyst is, in case of catalyst, the reaction follows a different path where activation energy required by reactants to form the activated complex decreases. So presence of a catalyst decreases the activation energy, thereby increasing the rate of the reaction. Does it change anything else? Now, presence of a catalyst may alter the path of the reaction. However, the enthalpy change, can you people tell me what happens to enthalpy change? What happens to enthalpy change in presence of a catalyst? If a catalyst is used in a reaction, does the enthalpy of the reaction gets affected? Is the question. No idea? Okay. This catalyst and related graph will throw some light on all these aspects in the next class itself. As of now, today it's enough. Okay. Now, in the in one more class, probably we'll complete this chapter and start next chapter in sequence. I think thermodynamics is there in your list. Briefing of the concepts can be taken. So for today, it's enough. We'll continue the discussion of that list and etc. in the next class. Okay, thank you very much. We'll stop at this stage. Among sharing slides can be done. Okay, that so in the next class we are going to complete this. Once for all, I'll share all these slides.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.